फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज नेक्स्ट वीडियो फ्रॉम टॉपिक थर्मोडायनेमिक्स 12th फिजिक्स फ्रॉम HSC बोर्ड. लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस, आइसोबैरिक प्रोसेस, आइसोपोरिक प्रोसेस. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेस, द प्रोसेस इन विच देयर इज नो हीट एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द सिस्टम एंड सराउंडिंग इज नोन एज एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेस. देयर इज नो हीट एक्सचेंज, दैट मीन्स क्यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो फॉर एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेस. सो दैट देयर इज नो हीट एक्सचेंज द प्रोसेस, देयर आर टू वेज सो दैट देयर इज नो हीट एक्सचेंज बिटवीन सिस्टम एंड सराउंडिंग. फर्स्टली द सिस्टम शुड बी थर्मली आइसोलेटेड so that there will be no heat exchange between system and surrounding. Thermal insulation must be there. Or another way is that the process should be rapid process so that there is no sufficient time for heat exchange. For example, abrupt puncturing of inflated balloon. Okay, that means when the balloon is punctured, so the air rushes inside, air inside rushes out. So it is very fast process. So there is no heat exchange between system and surrounding. So this is nothing but adiabatic process. Okay, we know that the first law of thermodynamics. So dQ is equal to dU plus dW. This statement also can be written as Q is equal to delta U plus W. Okay, so for adiabatic process, Q is equal to zero. So this side is zero. Therefore, delta U is equal to minus W. Okay. Delta U is equal to minus W, change in internal energy, and this W is nothing but work done. So when gas expands, that means volume expansion is there. Okay, volume expansion is there. Work done is by the gas. Okay, so work done is by the gas. So it is positive. Work done is positive. Work done is by the gas and it is positive. So as work done is positive, internal energy is negative. Internal energy, it is negative. Okay. So if there is compression, compression of gas, so work done is on the gas. Here work is done on the gas, so work done is negative. Work done is negative here, and internal energy here is positive. See here, when volume expansion is there, work done is by the gas, work done is positive, internal energy is negative. Okay, so volume compression is there, that times work done is on the gas, work done is negative, internal energy is positive. So PV diagram for isothermal process. See here, so this is vertical is pressure axis, it is volume axis. So PI, PF, VI, VF. We know that when pressure decreases, volume increases. So initial state A, final state B. So this is PV diagram for adiabatic process. Now we are going to study thermodynamics of adiabatic process. Okay, we will see what is thermodynamics. form of adiabatic process. See here, for adiabatic process, we know the relation PV raised to gamma is equal to constant C. Okay, for adiabatic process, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant C. That means PF VF raised to gamma is equal to PI VI raised to gamma, which is equal to constant C. Gamma here, we know that it is ratio of specific heats. Gamma is the ratio of specific heats. Specific heat at constant pressure to the specific heat at constant volume. Okay, so in the last topic, kinetic theory of gases, we have seen that gamma for monoatomic gases, okay, gamma for monoatomic gases, it is equal to 5 by 3. Gamma for diatomic gases, it is equal to 7 by 5. And gamma for polyatomic gases, it is 4 divided by 3. So these are values for gamma, that is ratio of specific heat at constant pressure to the specific heat at constant volume. Okay, now we will move to the work done. Again, one more relation is there, change in internal energy delta U or du, it is equal to Cv delta T. Okay, so see here, work done during adiabatic process when the volume changes from Vi to Vf is given by integration of PdV. Work done is integration of PdV. But we know that PV raised to gamma is equal to C. Therefore, P is equal to C divided by V raised to gamma. P is equal to C divided by V raised to gamma. I will substitute here. Integration of C divided by V raised to gamma into dV. Okay. So, I will take C outside the integration sign. C integration of dV divided by V raised to gamma. Okay. So, see here, in the denominator, it is plus gamma. When I will take it into the numerator, it will be minus gamma. C into integration of V raised to minus gamma into dV. See here, this V raised to plus gamma. When it will come to the numerator, it will be V raised to minus gamma dV. Now, we know the formula for integration, that is integration of x raised to n is equal to x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Okay. So, this formula I will use here. So, work done. W is equal to C as it is. Okay. So, I will make the integration V raised to minus gamma. So, power plus 1 V raised to minus gamma plus 1 in the denominator, minus gamma plus 1 within the limits Vi to Vf. See here, integration of x raised to n is x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So, minus gamma is here, minus gamma plus 1, minus gamma plus 1. So, this minus gamma plus 1, I will take 1 here and minus gamma on the other side. So, see, V raised to minus gamma plus 1 and in the denominator 1 minus gamma limits as it is. So, I have taken 1 to this side only. Okay. So, V raised to minus gamma plus 1 upon 1 minus gamma. The limits are same. So, this 1 minus gamma I will take outside the bracket. So, C divided by 1 minus gamma. So, here is V raised to minus gamma plus 1. Okay. So, I will take this V and this bracket, this whole term to the denominator. So when it will come to the denominator, it will be negative. C divided by 1 minus gamma and 1 divided by V raised to minus of minus gamma plus 1. See here, only I have done that. This whole term I have taken to the denominator. When this term comes to the denominator, it becomes negative. This bracket becomes negative because it is in the denominator now. Okay, so I will take this minus sign inside. So, see here, W is equal to C divided by 1 minus gamma and 1 divided by, see, minus gamma, minus minus, plus gamma, V raised to gamma, and this minus and plus, it will become minus 1, gamma minus 1, within the limits Vi to Vf. Okay, so I will substitute now limits. So it is equal to W is equal to C divided by 1 minus gamma, and this 1 divided by, instead of V, I will substitute upper limit, Vf raised to gamma minus 1 minus 1 divided by, instead of V, I will substitute lower limit, Vi raised to gamma minus 1. Now, I will take this C inside. I will take this C inside. And value of C, I will write as PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. That means PF, Vf raised to gamma, Pi, Vi raised to gamma. I will substitute. So, see here, C, I will take inside the bracket. So, it will not be there, 1 minus gamma. So, here Vf is there, I will take Pf, Vf raised to gamma. Instead of C, I will take Pf, Vf raised to gamma. And C will be here also. Okay, Vf raised to gamma minus 1. So, instead of this C, I will write Pi, Vi raised to gamma. Pi, Vi raised to gamma. And in the denominator, Vi raised to gamma minus 1 as it is. Now see here, this is nothing but Vf raised to gamma, Vf raised to minus 1. So Vf raised to gamma, Vf raised to gamma cancels here. So it will be 1 divided by 1 minus gamma and Pf divided by Vf raised to minus 1 only. See here, Pf, Vf raised to minus 1 only. Here also, Pi as it is. This Vi raised to gamma, Vi raised to gamma cancels. And only Vi raised to minus 1 remains. So, it is equal to, see here, 1 minus gamma, I will write here, 1 minus gamma, I will write to the total denominator. And this Vf raised to minus 1 goes to the numerator. It becomes plus. This minus 1 goes to the numerator and becomes plus 1. So, it is Pf Vf minus. This Vi raised to minus 1 comes to the numerator. It becomes plus. This is Pi Vi. So, this W is equal to Pf Vf minus Pi Vi divided by 1 minus gamma. Instead of P, we can write PV, we can write NRT. Therefore, this can be also written as NR in bracket TI minus TF in the denominator 1 minus gamma also. So, this is formula for work done. Okay? Next is cyclic process. Okay, cyclic process is the process that returns a system to its initial state. Process that returns to a system to its initial state means process starts from initial state, go to other point, and again it goes to the same point, same initial point. Cl. Process has started from point A. It is moved to point B. Okay, here. And again it has moved to the initial state. It is known as cyclic process. The process that returns the system to its initial state. So, in this process, change in internal energy is zero. Total change in internal energy is zero. That means delta U is zero. According to first law of thermodynamics, delta Q is equal to delta U plus W. So, as delta U is zero, Q is equal to W. Q is equal to W. So, this is cyclic process. Okay, PV diagram for cyclic process is like this. Process starts from point A, moves to B and then to A again. Initial state A again. So, this is cyclic process. And next one is free expansion. For example, when the balloon is ruptured, okay, so air inside moves outside very rapidly. Okay, so it is also adiabatic expansion. There is no sufficient time for heat exchange between system and surrounding. So Q is equal to zero, work done is also zero. So this we can define as uncontrolled change. This is free expansion is nothing but uncontrolled change. So these are different points we have studied in the topic thermodynamics.